Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Carlo Oller. I am an emergency physician with the channel Dr.ER.tv. In this video, we're gonna talk about how to study, a subject I wish somebody would have taught me. I wish my children would listen to me when I tell them, do this, do that. But of course they don't, but maybe you will by learning this simple, repetitive things that's gonna help you so much if you do it today. And why am I an expert on this? I wouldn't say an expert, but I know a whole lot about it. I've taken hundreds and hundreds of tests. I graduated summa cum laude from college. That's a 4.0 average in science. I graduated magna cum laude with 3.96 of medical school. I was an alpha omega alpha, which is the American Honor Society for Medical School. I was chief resident. I passed my boards the first time around, and I've just excelled in studying. Not because I'm smarter than the other kids who were in my medical school, but because I probably studied in a more disciplined way. And I obeyed some patterns of health that really showed up and helped. So let's just get straight to it and learn these techniques. Number one, as I mentioned in the video I just posted previously, exercise. You have to exercise. Exercise increases the levels of different endorphins and dopamine levels and improves the hippocampus production of new nerve cells and growth of cells that are already there, therefore making you smarter, more attentive, able to recall better. I know you say there's no time to exercise when you have so much to study, but you take a 10-minute break, you go up and down the steps in the library. Hey, if you make some study or cue cards, you start going up the steps and downs, reviewing whatever, you can make up with what you get. Make that heart rate go up so where you're puffing and puffing, you're feeling the work, not just going up and down slowly. You have to break a little bit of a sweat, and that will activate your brain and allow you to learn better. Number two, eat healthy. You know, caffeine's great, caffeine, but don't overdo it. You need your sleep as well, but eat healthy. There's plenty of foods that are good for the brain. So if you snack on those things while you're eating, if you eat them routinely, your brain's just gonna have better capacity to learn and study. I'm gonna link the video of the top 15 foods that you can eat to help your brain. Number three, avoid distractions. I see my kids and they're listening to music or they have the phone on the side and it's going off with messages. I'm telling you, if I had a phone with this much access when I was in medical school, I'd be in trouble. Too much distractions, your brain needs to focus on what you're trying to learn, and constantly looking at messages takes away from that, and then you can't commit things to memory as you should. It's good to listen to music, but music without words on it, just the background music, it'll help avoid distractions of other noises, just a constant steady noise, and then you can focus on what you're doing. I found that my best study was actually not in the library because it's so quiet and then any noise would distract me. Rather, I would study in the cafeteria where there's constant noise, but it was a steady level noise, a constant on the background. Therefore, I could kind of focus. And then when I got tired, I could look around and not look at anything specific, but just kind of let my mind wander a little bit, rest my mind, and be ready for the next set of whatever I wanted to read or study. So music's good, especially classical music, to enhance those neurons, to activate other areas of the brain as you're studying. And if you can use some, put your own words to the music, make a little music thing, that'll help even more with your memory. Number four, active learning. Not just read a page or two. Stop, summarize in your mind, try to speak it as if you were gonna teach it. And if you can teach it, you know it. In medicine, we have a saying, see one, do one, teach one. That means that you have to be able to do and teach that quick. So if you read a paragraph or two, summarize in your mind, figure out what the important elements of what you just read, and not figure out at the end of the chapter, you're like, I don't know what I just read. You should never do that. Then highlight what's important. I used to see people highlight the whole book. Brain doesn't do anything with that. You highlight certain key words so that when you're kind of flipping through pages, when you have an extra 5 minutes to review something, it highlights the word and you go in your mind, okay, that word's important, because think in your mind, figure out in your mind What would you ask if you were the professor or the physician or the whatever is asking you the next question on the test? And if you can figure out what they're gonna ask you, you'll be surprised how many times you're gonna guess it right. Number five, write up note cards. Through college, I had hundreds of these. I would do fill in the blanks. I would do list the three of this. Now have the answers in the back. So that way, if I was on a bus, on a train, or on a traffic jam, and I'm just driving, sitting there, I could just look over my cards and use time effectively. I went to get a haircut, boom. I'm in the restaurant eating a burger, boom. You know, because we forget so much of what we just read and we studied that unless you do cue cards, you can't really relearn and really commit things to memory. You have to be repetitive and you have to choose what you're gonna put in the note cards, not the whole book. The 15, 20 things that you absolutely know you have to remember for that test. So write up note cards. And this is the most important one, create mnemonics. Mnemonics are special memorization tools where you create this vivid imagery of what you're trying to learn. You turn the atom into a superhero and he destroys the other atom, and yes, you put emotion and the hero's crying, and you put a smell, and you do those kinds of things, because the more senses you put to your story, the more likely your brain's gonna remember. I have mnemonics that I learned in college that I still know today. I've known answers to questions that are really hard because it was a complicated name, like hydroxyapatite, which is like a special molecule that makes up the bone. And during an anatomy lecture, I was able to look at a formula and say, that's the formula for bones. And the professor was like, whoa, how did you know that? It's because at some point I thought, oh, that's a cool thing to know. And I turned it into an image, the words into an image, and I committed it to memory through the use of imagery and mnemonics. So those are my top six suggestions about how to study, exercise, eat healthy, avoid distractions, listen to background noise, but not anything in particular. Active learning, summarize what you learn, say it to somebody, explain it to someone. Write up note cards so you can go back, and if you have an extra 5 minutes before the test, you're not just carrying a book, I don't know what to study, but you know the five or six things that you have to study, review, and learn. And lastly, spend your time well, creating this vivid imagery and mnemonic, and you're gonna remember things that are gonna be in your memory for a long, long time, and at some point, is gonna pay off. So I hope you enjoy this video. Please leave your comments below. Like and subscribe if you like the video. And check out this other company who does a whole book, a whole basically a teaching module on how to study. And if you're on your way to college, medical school, nursing school, paramedic school, anything, this applies to any kind of study, anybody who's studying. That's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.